back again. I should probably paint my supercharger parts. For moving ahead to the left boom assembly. So let's see, F56 and F31. Do we even have these colors? XF56, this metallic gray. And X31 is titanium gold. Wow. And X7 flat red. So it'd just be like a rust component. 56 and 31. 56 and 7. And then 56 and 31. 56 and 7. And X16 is aluminum. No. Yes. So I need to find flat aluminum. XF7 is flat red. Titanium gold. I wonder if gold leaf will work. Which one is that? Titanium gold, X31.
Pretty sure I had metallic gray. German gray. Flat black. Metallic gray.
Okay. XF56. So let's see, this whole sucker is metallic gray, so I can hold those by this piece because that piece isn't going to be exposed. So it's metallic gray and red for a rust type tone. XF56 and X31. Now that's the one I'm gonna see if gold leaf. I wonder what the difference between titanium gold and gold leaf is. I wonder how much of a difference that'll make. I'll have to experiment with that. And then flat red. So let me see. XF5, XF1. Little sticks I'll probably brush paint in enamel. And X, so these pieces are going to be two pieces and that little bit. Wowzers. So five of five drops of this and one drop of this. Gonna be six, so it's gonna be 12 drops. Let's paint those and that end piece. Compressor activated. I'm going to re-up my syringe here. Sure, I'm not going to need to muscle these open. Oh, man. This is what happens when you wait so long in between painting. There we go. And there we go. Five of these, six, 12. So it's not going to take much. So let's see here. Dippers, zipper dippers. This is off to the side a little bit here, but that'll be fine. And I better move the instructions, lest I start painting them, and move the plane, lest overspray get all over it. Tamiya metallics, you always got to check for pigment at the bottom, make sure it's stirred in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And one drop of flat red. Yeah, that one drop of flat red didn't do much. I guess it did a little bit. So, here we go. Yeah. Pachoing. Go shooting across the room. One. That's it. That was empty. It was empty to begin with. I really don't know what I'm gonna do, how this flat gold, or how this gold leaf is gonna work out. I have titanium silver, I don't have titanium gold. And the instructions call for a mix of the metallic gray and titanium gold. And I need to wait a moment because I'm gonna need to brush paint just a tiny bit of it on those tubular pieces. And then the ends of those will be aluminum. I'll use enamel aluminum. The enamel aluminum has a better finish than the acrylic aluminum. I guess it has to do with the pigment grain size. Steel. Where is my aluminum? Steel. I thought I painted the top of it. That's brass. Not that I thought it was aluminum, but just wondering what it was. Black. There's flat aluminum, but that looks like it's never been opened. I should have another one around here that's been opened. Metallic silver. That's metallic silver too. That's flat aluminum. Huh. Look at that. Can you see that? No, you can't. These are the same paint. They're both pretty much brand new. One's got a lot more pigment in it than the other one. Graphite. Okay. Dark iron, rubber black, rubber black. Okie dokie smokey. So these two pieces get the 56 and 31, and 31 is the titanium gold. So let me mix up a batch of this and see what it's going to look like. 2-to-1 using gold leaf. And metallic gray. Just gonna mix up a wicked small batch. 2, 3. Go a little more. Hmm. When in doubt, improvise. One, two, now this has a little more thinner than the batch will have. Gonna look like. Oh, and I missed the cup. Or I didn't miss the cup, but I missed the paint in the cup. Making much of a difference. Not making much of a difference. I hate to have these, you know, colors so close to each other and not even be able to tell them apart. I can see a little bit of the gold coming through. Definitely looks a little lighter than the other. So, clear my cup. Do one, two, three. Two, three, four. Six, seven, eight. So I'm just gonna wing this ratio because I don't have the titanium gold paint that it wants me to have, and I do want this color to look noticeably different than the other color. One, two, 3, 4. So I'm just going to do, instead of a 2-to-1, I'm just going to do a 1-to-1 ratio. Whoa. So we're winging it here on Father's Day. Actually got a little gray on that one. glue down in the cup a little bit to prevent the bubbles from rising up too much. Ah, on the floor. Tell you what, let me stick these down because where's my tape dispenser? Where's my tape dispenser? Oh, right in front of me. Dog hair. These also same color, but I think I can wedge these onto a flat toothpick to hold them steady. Yeah, that'll work. That'll work. There's a little color difference there. Subtle shades. You can see the gold coming through. They actually look pretty good. Roll onto the side that's finished. And then I need a little brushy brush. That's a decent one. Sort of tell the difference. For brushing, that's really thin because it's mixed for spraying. So I have to be sure to give it a couple coats. Dry, please.
So let's give that a moment to dry, and I'll try and apply another little coat on those two with the brush. And then the pipes get hit with aluminum, and the ends of the these tips get hit with chrome silver. Chrome silver is wonderful looking stuff. Father's Day blowjob therapy there. I wonder if this concoction's paint, if it's supposed to resemble steel, because it kind of looks that way. But like I said, I didn't have the requested titanium gold. Should have bought that when I bought the titanium silver, which I initially bought for doing, like, you know, jet engines. Oh, good. I'm out of Q-tips. So I'm finally going to use the brand name Q-tips. I had tried to economize and use some cheap grocery store brand, and those things just went fuzzy, man. Every time I used one, I got fuzz everywhere. And I know I've used the Johnson & Johnson Q-tip brand before, and they are a superior cotton swab. Looks like my feed is buffering. Is that so? Back so I don't splash them. Brush clean, compressor off. I need to change my lacquer thinner here. It's getting a little saturated with paint cleanings.
Alrighty, just a moment for those pieces to dry, and then I'll use some of this flat aluminium. Just shake up both of these. This one, I need to clean this one up. To the pick. Make sure there's no pigment sticking to the bottom. Subtle little color difference there. Being one of my favorite brushes for this size work. Got a stray hair. Let me clean it first. It's truly a problematic hair. It'll still be sticking out. If not, this will put it back in place. That might be it right there. Yep. Damn my eyes. Damn my eyes.
we go. Oh, no, I need that. Stick these down again, hanging off the edge. I don't want to touch them because I'll leave a fingerprint on them. Yo. And this one needs to be cleaned up too. This one might need a little hit of lacquer thinner to get it clean. Morning, my son. How are you?
Good. Happy Father's Day.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
To my dear parental figure.
Thank you, son.
But of course.
Mom gave me a couple Gonker packs of beef jerky. Yeah, man. I'd never seen that brand before. And they're just big hulking slabs of meat that have been jerkyized.
You think that's better than big slabs of meat that's been jerkyized?
It's not too much better. Although, since it is like noon already, I did make myself a rather hefty hamburger with that leftover ground beef from the other night.
Exciting.
And that was pretty satisfying.
Right.
We had leftover buns and everything.
Say Happy Father's Day, Sasha?
Nah, Sasha's already been out barking at the nobodies. The barky barker. That'll do. I might have to hit that again. Again, there's not much of a difference in shade there. I'll tell you what though, these pieces that I hit in flat aluminum, I might hit them in chrome silver just so that they have a little better pop factor. That flat aluminum looks too similar to the other shades. And that might help, you know, make a better sort of presentation. But for now, let all that dry and see if I need to hit it again. And a little later this afternoon, I'll be moving ahead to the booms, working on the side booms. So that's it for now.